Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. Welcome to Tattletales. Thank you. That was lovely. Oh, yes. Hello, everybody. Welcome. Thank you for coming to see us here in the studio, and thank you for tuning us in at home. Oh, you're going to have a good time today. We have a rookie couple, someone you've never seen on Tattletales before. You've seen him a lot, though, and you're going to know who he is. And two other couples that you have definitely seen on Tattletales before, and they're back because they're so much fun here. Here they are, winning money for the blue section today. The star of The Price is Right, Mr. Bob Barker and his wife, Dorothy Jo. Winning money today. For the banana section, William Shatner and his wife, Marcy Lafferty. Winning money today for the red section, he's the rookie, Mr. Pat Cooper and his wife, also a rookie, Patty Cooper. See, Pat, it takes a while for our audience to warm up. You can see that.
Oh, I can see that.
They start kind of dull and slow. Isn't that a reception?
Isn't that lovely?
Let me just remind you guys before we say anything else. The object is, and it's a good way to think about it, is that I asked the ladies the question. They are answering the question the best they know how, honestly. You guys' job, your job, is to figure out how they're going to answer it. If they try to figure out how you're going to answer, you'll be here till, you know, whatever. First things first. Next thing is The Price is Right has a new time period,
That's right.
We should remind them, Bob.
Well, it'd be my pleasure. We're on at 10 o'clock in the east, 10 to 11 in the east now, and 9 to 10 in the west.
Right.
And not only that match game, which was so popular in the afternoon, is now in the morning immediately after our show.
At what time?
At 11 o'clock in the east and 10 in the west.
Right.
So if you watch at 11 o'clock in the east and at 10 o'clock in the west, you can still see Gene and Brett Summers fighting on match games.
Yes, right. What if you live in Kansas?
If you live in Kansas,
it's on radio.
You probably watch it about... that's right. The picture's not good, but it's on radio in Kansas.
It's a simulcast. The times can make you crazy. People say, oh, I see you in Miami. And I say, what time? 9:30. 9:30 when? In the morning or the evening? Could be either place. We have a show to do here.
So long as they see.
So long as they see. Everybody watches Price. Here we go. Ladies, the first question is for you. It's worth $150 to your rooting sections. When your husband is away, do you sleep at night better than usual, worse than usual, or the same as usual? Okay? Think it over. These guys are on the road a bit. When your husband is away, do you sleep at night better than usual, worse than usual, or the same as usual? Off you go. You're in trouble no matter what happens here. You know that, don't you, fellas? Bob, what would Dorothy Jo say?
Well, Dorothy Jo doesn't sleep, whether I'm home or whether I'm away.
She's an insomniac.
Well, no, she wakes up at like 3:30 or 4 o'clock. She's up and dusting. She gets up and dusts. How? No, that she does.
You?
No, not me. But, She's dusting the house, but often she is dusting like the head of the bed at 4 o'clock in the morning. And I finally ask her not to do that.
Yeah.
And she's been pretty nice. She now dusts the foot of the bed. But she gets up very early in the morning. And I think that when I'm away, that she gets up even earlier. I think she sleeps. Your answers are worse, better, or just the same.
Yes.
Worse. She sleeps worse when I'm away.
When you're not there.
Yes.
So how many hours sleep a night does she get on an average?
Well, she goes to sleep about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, too,
That means she's had a good night's rest.
As a matter of fact, we better hurry along. She's getting sleepy back there right now.
Past her bedtime.
No,
if you watch in New York, we're into her bedtime now.
She has a Spanish television show that she watches from Mexico from 8 to 9.
Yeah.
And after 9 o'clock, and of course then she's had a quart of tequila by then, too, so... She gets plenty of sleep.
Yeah, okay. The answer is worse, though, when you're
when
away.
When I'm away, she...
Here she comes. No, she knew. Hello there, Dorothy Jo.
Hi.
When Bob is away, do you sleep at night better than usual, worse than usual, or the same as usual?
You know, it had never occurred to me to think about this, so I suppose
It must be the same.
No.
No? That's interesting, though.
What did he think?
The barkers are off to their usual beginning.
No, what did he think?
He said that it would be a little worse, probably.
Oh, yeah, well.
I thought that you told me that you did not sleep as well.
Well, I answer the phone. Barker always answers the phone.
That's right. I call her a lot.
At 4 in the morning, you call her? All right. We know all there is to know about your sleeping habits, Dorothy Jo.
Yeah,
you'll
thanks.
Be pleased to know that.
Yeah,
sorry about
do.
That. Bill, what will Marcy say?
Well, I'm away a fair amount of the time, and we have these large Dobermans roaming the property. We breed Dobermans and have a number of them, and they kind of take care of the property and mark their spots where they went.
Yes.
And a couple of them even sleep with Marcy when I'm not there.
Uh-huh.
She dusts them, too.
Yes.
But the dog does not take my place, I must assure you.
Oh, I'm glad.
She does not sleep as well.
Not as well.
I don't think.
No.
I didn't either.
it's very hard to sleep when your partner's doing this all night. You better believe it.
That's Marcy. You should see the dog.
Okay.
You know, he did that very well. I'd ask Marcy about Bert Convy.
No. Those Dobermans are big. You should see them. They never dust a Doberman. I've always said that. Marcy will sleep...
not as well.
Worse than usual. Here she comes. Marcy, when Bill is not away, do you sleep at night better than usual, worse than usual, or the same as usual?
The only members of our family who sleep better when he's away are our dogs. No, I do not sleep as well at all.
That's correct. He said worse, and you're right.
The reason they sleep better...
Nothing.
The reason they sleep better is because they get to sleep with me.
Yeah,
they
right.
really love that.
I can understand that.
Hey, Marcy, Marcy, bow wow.
Never mind.
You're right, Marcy. Your bark is worse than your bite.
Oh, yes? Has he ever bit you?
That's what I heard about.
It's murder. Pat, what will Patty say to this?
My wife is known as the zombie in pantyhose. She very rarely sleeps, my wife. But when I'm gone, I got to say, whatever sleep she does have or do, is worse when I'm not at home.
It's worse.
Yes.
You're away a lot. I mean, you're playing in clubs.
Yeah, about 30 weeks a year, I would say.
30 weeks
yes.
a year. She
yes.
has plenty of practice.
And my second family in New York, they're getting crazy, too. Oh, she finds out we're in trouble. It's not easy. It is.
We'll have them on next week and see how it goes. With
they are on next week. What do you mean? You're going to have them.
Sorry. Okay, you'll say worse. Here she comes. Patty, when Pat is away, do you sleep at night better than usual, worse than usual, or the same as usual?
Well, I hope he got this right now. I would say the same.
No, he said... that's very interesting.
I knew he would say the worst, because I am the worst sleeper anyway.
Yeah.
So I sleep bad when he's there, and I sleep bad when he's not there.
I see.
I didn't think he
should. She always tells
right.
me, says, boy, I can't wait till you go home so I can get some good sleep.
Yeah.
I sleep terrible when you're away. Now she's saying something else.
Hmm. Oh.
Get the lawyers.
No. You see, that's rookie's luck. I mean, it can go either way.
This is on now?
This is the air.
Oh, I thought this was the rehearsal.
No, this is it. This is the real thing here.
Okay.
And you blew the first one.
Yes, I did.
Got a long
Sorry.
Way to go, Pat. Marcy and Bill, didn't they get the whole thing for the banana to start things off? We'll come back with question number one in just a second. Time out to sleep as usual. Won't you?
Stay tuned for more of Bob Barker's Birthday Bash on GSN. On Christmas Day, GSN is showing holiday episodes of your favorite game shows. We've got Dawson nipping at your nose, Kennedy dancing like an ice queen, Santa's falling, and Lingo Balls lingoing all the way. It's GSN's Christmas gift. Open it up on Christmas Day at noon Eastern on GSN.
Why is Jell-O introducing 100-calorie smoothie snacks? Because something magical happens when you blend just the right amount of fruit with just the right amount of milk. Something that makes people go, mmm. New Jell-O smoothie snacks. Because it's magic.
Attention. Here's how to win your free Auto Go from Rascal.
This is the revolutionary Auto Go, the most unique personal mobility vehicle anywhere. The Auto Go folding electric vehicle has power, versatility, and it's so incredibly portable you can take it with you by car, train, bus, or plane. And now, how would you like to get one of these absolutely free? Call today and you'll have up to 12 chances to win, because during this special introductory offer, we're giving away an AutoGo every month for a full year. With its unique power fold feature, the AutoGo folds in just seconds automatically using its own power. So you're always ready to go on your own. You'll be amazed by the portability of your AutoGo, and its power folding design gives you more options for mobility than any other vehicle ever invented. It's great for getting around in tight spaces at home or in stores, and outdoors with plenty of power to spare. There's nothing else like it. The AutoGo is your ticket to freedom and independence. Narrow doorways or store aisles are no problem for the AutoGo. And it's rugged enough to travel on grass or gravel. Plus, because it's made from ultra-durable die-cast aluminum, the AutoGo is 50% lighter than other vehicles and can carry riders weighing up to 300 pounds. Getting around has never been this easy or this much fun. So call now and get up to 12 chances to win your AutoGo absolutely free. Do all the things you want to do and go all the places you want to go on this incredible vehicle. Call now for your chance to win the revolutionary AutoGo.
Don't miss your chance to win an AutoGo. Call 1-800-418-8866. There's no obligation, so why wait? Call 1-800-418-8866. Remember, the sooner you call, the more chances you'll have to win. Call today, 1-800-418-8866.
More questions.
What band did Paul McCartney form after the Beatles broke up?
More answers.
B. Garth Brooks.
D. Baboon.
A. Moyer.
More contestants. More winners. More Regis.
Is that your final answer?
GSN gives you more millions on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire with Regis Philbin. Every night at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
Let's play.
Hurry, hurry, step right up and check out the best GSN's Daytime Game Gallery. At 11, Dick Clark is the big money target on the $100,000 pyramid. At 11:30, this show's rated X and O. Tom Bergeron hosts Hollywood Squares. At 12, Bob Eubanks takes aim at marital bliss on the Newlywed Game. And at 12:30, Chuck Woolery sells kisses for a buck on Love Connection. So take your best shot, because these shows always hit the mark. GSN's Daytime Game Gallery, weekdays at 11 Eastern, 8 Pacific on GSN.
Introducing Blade Holiday Memories 3-in-1 Candle. Created by nature, captured by Blade.
It's amazing how something so little can be so powerful. Like the Dirt Devil Power Stick Vacuum. It's the only stick vac with 12 amps to give you all the power of a full size with the convenience of a lightweight, which makes it perfect for all types of bare floors and those hard to reach places. Plus, no bags to buy ever. The Dirt Devil Power Stick Vacuum. Nothing escapes the power of a Dirt Devil.
Little. Hello. Question number two. This is it. If you are ready, the bananas have all the bread.
It's a banana sandwich.
Oh, look at them, two of them, both of them. Wow, you guys are so fast. Listen, ladies, this is for you. $150. If our magic genie came to you and offered you either money or more friends, which would you choose? Pretty good question. If our magic genie came to you and offered you either money or more friends, huh? What did I say? Oh, I just said money. Oh, if he offered you more money. Or, see, I just saw money and said money. I never even saw the more. If our magic genie came to you and offered you either more money or more friends, that's the way it goes, which would you choose? Okay? Off you go. Money's money. I mean, more money is, if he offers you money, it's more than you had, isn't it? Bob? Oh, no, we start with Bill. What will Marcy say? More money or more friends?
Yeah, I can't imagine anybody answering more money.
You can't, eh?
No, I really can't. either as a lie or as the truth or as a lie. I mean, imagine lying and saying... So I can't, there's just no way that Marcy's going to answer more money. She's going to say more friends. But I agree.
You
do?
Okay, you...
I wish I could have a... marvelously interesting answer for that, and a snapper and a laugh.
You don't have to.
She may have a marvelously interesting answer for it.
I got a feeling the snapper
that was a snapper.
Okay, here she comes. Marcy, if our magic genie came to you and offered you either more money or more friends, which would you choose?
More money.
No. There's your answer, sir.
We planned that.
Yeah.
We wanted to give you that.
Yeah, right. Yes, of course. Marcy, would you like to explain that? I think you should, because I think it's fun.
I can't. I have such wonderful friends. I don't feel the need for more. I don't have enough time for the ones I have. And so I picked money because you can't be too thin or too rich, okay?
Yeah, right. See, now remember, I asked Marcy the question. Good thought.
Yeah, but...
What'd you say?
If Marcy could take that answer back now and substitute something else, there's no question she'd say more friends.
Is that
no
right? Question. Marcy, let me ask you again.
now, wait a minute here.
No, we can't do that. Pat, what will Patty say?
That's the easiest question you could ask me on this show.
It is.
My wife was never a money person. She never went crazy about getting money and money, money, money. But you tell her she got a friend, boy, she'll bake you a cake.
We
got about 400 cakes in the refrigerator we haven't got rid of yet. If she don't like you, she'll bake you a cake.
Really?
If you get a cavity, she'll bake you a cake. In fact, you don't even know this. There's a cake for you right now in the dressing room.
Is that right?
Yes. You just can look at it because we have to bring it to another show. Okay. She'd rather have friends.
She would?
Yes.
You're positive of
that? Absolutely. I'll bet anything on
it. So was Bill. Here comes Patty now. If our magic genie came to you and offered you either more money, Patty, or more friends, which would you choose?
More friends.
That's the one. You got it. The rookies are on the board. Okay. You're absolutely right. And if I'd known you were going to say that, I'd baked you in a cake. Bob, what will Dorothy Jo say?
Well, until I heard Marcy's answer, I had this all figured out.
Yeah.
But the other day, I was out in the shopping mall with Dorothy Jo, and I was in a particularly good mood, I guess. And I said, what would you like? I said, let's go. And there were ladies' shops and jewelry stores and all these. I said, let me buy you something. What would you like? She said, Barker, I really don't want anything. I just don't want anything. So we didn't buy anything. Now, knowing that, it was only a few days ago, I would say she will say more friends.
Uh-huh.
So
that's it.
Turn it on and let's get it over.
Only thing you must remember is that she's had a few days to think that over.
That's right.
And now she's probably got a list.
Hey, Bob, I love your confidence.
You know how her mind works.
She's going to say, come to think of it, Bob, I've got something to tell you. Here she comes. Dorothy Jo, if our magic genie came to you and offered you either more money or more friends, which would you choose?
Well, I suppose if you have enough friends, you could always make some money, so I guess it's friends.
That's what the man said. Dorothy Jo and Bob and Patty and Pat are right. They split it in half. Nice tight game at halftime, fellas. Step to the rear. We'll bring the ladies out front. We'll come back in the second half in just a moment. Money or friends, gang?
My lymphoma had not only come back, but it was life-threatening.
After I discovered I was pregnant, I was diagnosed with breast cancer.
When I first found out that Frank had cancer, I felt like my whole world had fallen apart.
I went to one more hospital because I wasn't willing to give up.
Being treated like a real person for the first time in 10 years was such a relief.
I feel like it's just like going back home.
My son.
The kindness and compassion of Cancer Treatment Centers of America touch you the moment you call one of our cancer information specialists, who will send you this video and helpful information free. Please call today.
We as cancer patients, for whatever reason, have been dealt this kind of pain, but there is hope on the other side, and there is great life after cancer.
Can your radio do this? Only one radio can give you stereo sound this big, yet is small enough to fit almost anywhere. The extraordinary Wave Radio from Bose. Press the remote control and hear big, rich sound that fills the room. Sound so rich, popular science called it a sonic marvel. You hear music the way it was meant to be heard. Clear, full, incredibly lifelike. Order now to receive a free multimedia pedestal, a $99 value. It connects your radio to a TV, VCR, and virtually any other audio device simultaneously, so you can easily switch from source to source. Experience big stereo sound from a radio. Call now, and shipping is free. Be sure to ask about our financing options. Bose, better sound through research.
Warning, the following contains images of extreme outrageousness. Weeknights at 8, get ready for GSN's Host Gone Wild Primetime. The party is on as Regis dares contestants to go all the way on Millionaire.
Now we're talking naked.
Get down and dirty with Chuck Woolery, flashing five-letter clues on lingo.
All right!
Then rowdy stars match wits with party animal Gene Rayburn on Match Game.
My blank glows in the dark.
Uncensored, untamed, unbelievable. Host Gone Wild Primetime weeknights starting at 8 Eastern on GSN.
This is fun.
That to me, you got me all, hello. Second half coming up right now, as a matter of fact. And if you're ready to go, I have, look at three pretty ladies with me in the front. Fellas, we have a nice close game now. See, Pat, you and Bob are tied with $75 and Bill has $150. And this one, we got to move a little. Men, psychologists say that a good way to stop arguing is to take off your clothes because it's difficult to argue in the nude. Also dangerous. Tell me that. Have you ever argued while you were both in the nude, yes or no? That's a good question, folks, I think. A good way to stop an argument, psychologists say, is to take off your clothes because it's difficult to argue in the nude. Have you ever argued while you were both in the nude, yes or no? Goodbye, fellas. They're laughing pretty good. Patty, what will Pat say?
No, we've never argued in the nude.
Why
I'm married 15 years and forget it.
It's never happened.
I mean, he knocks on the door and says, psst, can I come in? I'm a little shy.
You're a little shy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I couldn't argue in the nude.
No, we've never
argued in the nude.
Oh, that's interesting. That's probably why psychologists say it's a good way to stop an argument.
Well, you see, there you go. That's probably why we're married 15 years.
Maybe so. I mean, if you're fighting in an argument, somebody starts to take their clothes off, you could burst out laughing.
Pretty weird.
Okay, you'll say no. You never have. Here he comes. Psychologists say that a good way to stop an argument is for you to take off your clothes because it's difficult to argue in the nude, right? Have you ever argued with Patty? Have you ever argued? Oh, here's the question. Have you ever argued while you were both in the nude? Yes or no, Pat?
Yeah, I think one time her mom was there too.
What? What?
Yes, we did.
No, Patty said no.
What? This morning? What happened to this morning?
Oh.
Honey, you haven't even, you've never seen me nude.
Now you come.
Oh, you see, now you...
See, I learned something, buddy.
Yeah. Thank you, Pat.
I mean, it's dark, you know.
Yeah, you've learned something. It's right. Dorothy Jo, what would Bob say?
Well, I think we've argued almost under any circumstance, but I cannot remember once standing around naked and having a fight. I'd say never.
Okay, you'll say no, you never have. It's a good question. I like this. Bob... Bob, have you ever argued while you were both in the nude, yes or no?
Oh, this is a very difficult question because there are so many years involved. Dorothy Jo and I were born married. And I have really been thinking about it, and I cannot remember ever arguing in the nude.
That's correct. That's exactly what the lady said.
I don't know. There was...
Steady, Blues, steady.
There was one occasion about 18 years ago when we almost did, but I still had my left bedroom slipper on.
Uh-huh. So then you don't qualify.
No.
Sorry, sir. Marcy, what will Bill say?
Well, you know, I'm sure that we have. I think that's very true. It's hard, too, because if you forget about the argument and start realizing what you're doing,
yeah.
It's silly, and yeah. You can't, but we yeah. have.
You have? Oh, yes. You have, eh?
Yes.
Do you remember a specific
about it? It's no big argument, but yes, I do remember a specific time. I don't know if... Mm-hmm.
Do you remember anything else about it that you'd care to mention?
No.
No. Okay. Do the best I can. It is called Tattletales, you know. All right, you'll say yes. Here comes Bill. Bill, have you ever argued... Both of you argued while you were both in the nude, yes or no?
It would be very difficult to argue in the nude. I would think you wouldn't know what to address yourself to.
Yeah.
I'd say no.
No, Marcy said yes. She knew.
Well, I guess she knew where to look.
She knew where to look. Or what to yell at. Dorothy, Joe, and Bob are right and get the whole thing for the blue section. And we'll come back in a moment with a $300 question and we'll decide it. So put something on and we'll talk.
Stop. This one. A couple papers, mail's in a mailbox.
Yeah. Give me the package.
They think the signs read, no one is home.
Mom, what's going on?
yet they missed the most important sign of all.
It's okay. It's okay. Hello? It's Brinks. It's okay.
Brinks Home Security protected this family, and they can help protect yours, too. The Brinks Award-winning Monitoring Center provides a quick link to the proper authorities 24 hours a day. Call Brinks Home Security now and get a free 10-point home security analysis. The Brinks Standard System with keypad installed for just $99, and will install a second keypad free. That's a $125 value. You'll always feel safe at home with Brinks Home Security. Brinks Home Security, dedicated to fast response and peace of mind 24 hours a day. Call now.
A while back, I started to notice something about my hearing.
I couldn't always hear everything.
Certain words.
I kept turning up the TV.
I wanted to hear better, but I wasn't ready to wear a hearing aid. Then I found this incredible new device called Songbird, the world's number one disposable hearing aid.
It's this tiny little device
that's clear, so it matches any skin tone, and it's virtually invisible.
You wear it when you need it, like sunglasses. To hear better in the situations where you really need to, Songbird contains the same digital technology as hearing aids that cost thousands, but you can get a Songbird for less than $100. And each Songbird lasts up to 3 months or about 400 hours. And when it runs out, you simply get a new one.
I bought Songbird for my husband so we can watch TV at a comfortable volume.
There's no exam, no batteries to replace, and no costly repairs. It's so easy to try.
If you have mild to moderate hearing loss, the simplest way to improve your hearing is just a phone call away. While other hearing aids cost thousands, the Songbird 400-hour digital hearing aid can be yours through this special introductory offer for only $59. Songbird is not available in stores. And best of all, your complete satisfaction is guaranteed, so you have nothing to lose.
No matter how you look at it, Songbird couldn't be any easier.
You use them when you need them, and you just pay for that, and that's it.
Sounds that you need to hear, your children, things like that that you're never going to hear again. Don't let that opportunity pass you by.
What you get from Songbird is as good as it gets, and it doesn't get any better.
Hear what you've been missing for a fraction of the cost of a traditional hearing aid. And for a limited time, you'll get this free protective case and a virtual audiologist video full of helpful information about your Songbird.
Call 1-800-675-0438 or order online at songbirdstore.com. Songbird, the simplest way to improve your hearing. Satisfaction guaranteed. Order now.
We have a little leak or something.
Holy moly.
Guess I better get started.
Right. But first, could you give me your price and the prices of some of your competitors?
You know, don't want to pay too much.
Hey! Our customers know the importance of shopping around. Because at Progressive.com, you can get our price for car insurance, plus the rates of other big-name companies. And that could save you hundreds. Visit Progressive.com today, your best source for finding a great deal.
Or if you'd rather talk to someone, give us a call anytime at 1-800-PROGRESSIVE.
Join the over 11 million people who choose Progressive for low rates and fast, friendly service. Visit Progressive.com or call 1-800-PROGRESSIVE. Not what you'd expect from an insurance company.
Hard work. Hello. This question is worth $300. This one will decide the issue. We're going to move it just a little bit. And you got to catch up with Dorothy, Joe, and Bob. They have come from behind and forged into the lead. Men, which of the two of you is more self-disciplined, you or your wife? Good question. Which of the two of you is more self-disciplined, you or your wife? Goodbye. We'll start with you, Patty, between you and Pat.
Okay, I think I'm more self-disciplined. I hope that's what he's going to answer. Bear with me, red section.
All right, you will say that he will say, and I'm asking him, too.
Yes, that
he will say you.
That I am the one who's most self-disciplined.
Right, here he comes.
Okay.
Pat, which of the two of you is more self-disciplined, you or Patty?
That's simple, my wife.
That's it.
That's simple.
It was simple for you.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Pat. Marcy, between you and Bill.
I'm afraid to answer another question. I am more self-disciplined.
You think so, huh?
I hope Bill says that. I really am. Oh, they don't believe it.
You hope he says
that. I don't blame you.
Because you hope he realizes that is what you're saying.
He.
In what way is he not as self-disciplined as he should be?
Oh, I didn't, that's not what I said. I just am more in every area, maybe compulsive about it.
I see. He is disciplined, but you're...
Oh, he's absolutely, I'm just, you said who's more. I didn't say to his detriment, he's not.
No, you didn't, you did not. And I don't mean, you may step down, I've released the witness, Your Honor. It's a, no, I didn't want to trap you. Which of the two of you is more self-disciplined? And you will say you are more so.
And I'm afraid.
No, don't be
afraid.
Because
he's going to go, he's going to say he is and I'm leaving.
No, don't you dare, here he comes. Captain, which of the two of you is more self-disciplined, you or Marcy?
I wish I had Marcy's discipline. She's more disciplined.
That's correct. That's what you said. Yeah.
Terrific.
You got it. Look at this. This is very interesting because this will decide the game right here. Dorothy Jo.
Yeah, and it sounds like we're all on an ego trip here, but I think Barker's going to say I am, although he is... He is very, we're both just, you know, all real great at it.
Yeah.
But I think he'll probably say I am.
You think he'll say you?
Yeah, right.
All right.
I guess.
Here he comes. Bob, this is for the game, sir. Which of the two of you is more self-disciplined, you or Dorothy Jo?
You said you wanted to move it along. I shall move it along. I am more self-disciplined.
No, that's not what Dorothy Jo said. You believe it?
The only reason he says that, I still smoke. I'm the only person in the world who still smokes. That was the key reason.
The doctor told her to stop smoking, and she is still smoking.
All right, Marcy.
I told her to stop insulting my mother, and she is still insulting my
Marcy, Bill, and Patty, and Pat split that $300 in half, and look who comes from behind and wins it. Marcy and Bill for the bananas. We will return in a moment. Give the bananas the bananas.
We'll be back with more of Bob Barker's Birthday Bash on Game Show Network.
Hello, Toys R... Whoa, no, calm down. I'm here to help. Take a deep breath. Tell me what you're looking for. Oh, those are very popular. But we still have plenty. I know. Oh, it's going to be okay.
Bye-bye.
Big guy freaking?
Oh, yeah.
It's your last chance for great deals on hard-to-find toys like Bullseye Ball, $15.99, Transformers Armada Unicron, $39.99, or Yu-Gi-Oh! Dual Disc Launcher, $39.99, only at Toys R Us.
It's a Black & Decker. It's Gizmo, the new Black & Decker cordless can opener. You can keep Gizmo in any handy spot, and the compact charger base goes anywhere. Charge it up. Gizmo's good for a month. Use Gizmo wherever you need it. You'll love your Black & Decker Gizmo, and so will anyone you give it to.
Gizmo, fun to give, great to get.
Man, I don't know why she's tripping. It was only weed. I only tried it once.
You're grounded. That means no phone.
Mom, come on.
Don't even think about it.
She doesn't love being tough. She's tough because she loves. She is the enforcer, and she knows she can make a difference.
When I say no weed, I mean no weed.
Yeah, you want to hit this? And get grounded again? Nah, man. I'm cold.
The enforcer. She's more than a hero. She's...
a good mom.
You're more powerful than you know.
What a chilly Wednesday across
this
the
Wednesday, drop what you're doing. It's the JCPenney Wednesday One Day Sale. Save 50% on terrific gifts store-wide. Save 50%. Where do you unwrap the magic?
It's all the inside.
JCPenney.
On January 1st, 2003, all seniors became entitled to a free United States Pharmaceutical Group discount prescription card. Simply show the card and you can save immediately on name brand and generic prescriptions. And it's free.
Now I'm getting my prescriptions at about half of what I used to pay.
We'll give everyone who calls a free discount prescription card so you can save immediately on name brand and generic prescriptions. There's no cost, no obligation. This card is free.
I can save 10, 20, 30, up to 50%. The United States Pharmaceutical Group's discount prescription card is free. Save immediately when you show the card at the pharmacy. There are no limits, no deductibles, and no claim forms. Everyone will be accepted. This plan is perfect for seniors and anyone without prescription insurance.
You can get great savings on all your prescriptions, including Glucophage, Glipizide, and Avandia.
Call now. And don't forget, the discount prescription card is free.
Call now, 1-800-375-9062.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
An all-new episode tonight at 9 Eastern and Pacific.
W, X, Y, and Z.
The big winners today, the Bananas, Marcy and Bill with $300. We will add $1,000. They will divide $1,300 in the Banana section. Thank you, everybody, for watching some Tattletales. We'll see you next time. Bird Conner saying so long. Thank you.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.